Terry. We could not have done it without your hard work, your phone calls, your bumper stickers, all of your hard work. Thank you very much. As Terry Branstad and I traveled to 99 counties, we had Iowans telling us they wanted an end to the uncertainty and they wanted to see stability return to government. Well, are you ready for 4 years of clean, honest, open, transparent government?
Thank you. Thank you, Kim, for that rousing introduction. Kim Reynolds, Lieutenant Governor. I like the way that sounds, don't you? Kim and you, I have fully met my political match. I didn't think anyone would work harder or be more enthusiastic about Iowa than I am. But I'll tell you what, I found out over the last 4 months, and the people of Iowa did too, you have got it. Thank you. I want you to know, I just visited with Governor Culver, and he graciously conceded the election. I thanked him for his service and for the rigorous campaign that he ran. He is a true competitor. When I was growing up on a farm near Leland, Iowa, I learned an old saying that I've always lived by: the harder you work, the luckier you get. Well, tonight, I feel like the luckiest guy on the face of the earth. I can't tell you what an honor it is to be asked by Iowans to serve as their governor again. And tonight, I'm more excited about the job ahead than I was the very first time I stood here before you on an election night. You see, it is a privilege to serve Iowans. This campaign reaffirmed what I've already known to be true. Iowans are the hardest working, most honest, caring, God-fearing people in America. Iowans believe that if you do what's right for the right reasons, good things will happen. Well, Iowans, I aim to prove you right. You may not always agree with everything that I do, but I will always do my best. I will always act with your best interest at heart. I will work tirelessly to right our ship of state, and we'll do it by balancing our budgets with no frills, no dimmicks, and no debt. We'll restore good, honest budgeting. We will be involved in creating good jobs for Iowans who are hungry for work and good paychecks. Yeah. Restoring the best education in the country for our kids. Yeah. Iowans deserve a government as good as its people. A smaller government that is lean, frugal, and efficient as the people we serve. And I won't rest until we make sure that it happens. But I know that I can't do it alone. I wouldn't have been successful tonight alone. Chris, the love of my wife. I have the most understanding wife in the world. And I want to thank her and my wonderful family. And they've been growing. Here, come on, you guys. Mackenzie. Bridget. Sophia. And Alexis. And the children as well. And Mackenzie, my granddaughter who's right here, I promise you that I will indeed have an app for what ails Iowa. For all that helped me in large ways and in small, I say sincerely, thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. But our work is not done. It has just begun. I need your help and the help of all Iowans of goodwill to complete this journey to remake our state. The task is great. The goals are ambitious. But we Iowans are a tough lot. We have endured much, and we are stronger for it. We are ready to create a state where good jobs abound, families thrive, and government lives within its means. We are uniquely positioned to do this, and I am ready to lead the change. Now, my 86-year-old dad, Edward, is here. And hey, I tell you, he used to work us pretty hard on the farm. After a full day of baling hay, we would climb the hill from the barn up to the house, all hot and sweaty and tired and ready to go to bed. And Dad would usually say something like this, "Well, we didn't get much done today, but we'll give it heck tomorrow." Well, Iowans, we got a little done today, but we'll give it heck for the next 4 years. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God bless America. And especially the great state of Iowa. Thank you very much.